That's the Model X.
FF91.
The car industry, after 100 years, is about to change like it's never changed before.
These are some of the first cars designed from the ground up as electrics with autonomous driving in mind.
Sooner or later, the electrified engines will get as important as the combustion engines are today.
The shift in powertrains won't only change how cars drive, it'll change how they look.
For more than 100 years, cars have been built pretty much the same way. This one from 1917 is just like most cars today, with a big engine up front and a transmission tunnel running right through the middle.
But all that is about to change.
We are in the midst of a huge disruption process. I think it's very important to come up with unique concepts, with something that stands out.
With electric cars, you don't need any of that big bulky stuff. Electric motors are tiny. They sit way in the front. You can push the front seats up. And the batteries sit under the floor, which is flat because there's no transmission tunnel.
It opens up a completely new chapter for designers worldwide.
I thought BMW came out of the gate with the i-Series a couple of years ago now. Really, really strong. And I think Tesla's done a good job as well.
Designers can now experiment with interior space in a whole new way, giving occupants a different type of experience. But not all are taking advantage. Snyder says there are more radical machines from upstarts like Tesla or Faraday Future. And the more traditional cars are being made by established automakers.
There still seems to be a sort of lack in exploration of potential proportions. They don't want to move too quickly and scare the public away. They're very sensitive to radical shifts, so finding the horizon of acceptability is tricky.
What we see now is just the tip of the iceberg, the very beginning of a radical change.
That experience is going to have to be something that you'll tell your friends about, more so than just the content or the horsepower. It's going to be the experience.